Karen Ivan, welcome to Holo Holo, the show that spotlights our very own talent. Today we highlight several people who are using their talents to help out others. From the youngest rock band in Hawaii, Chaotic 5, to Miss Hawaii Filipina, Erica Joy Ordonez. And we also talk to One Legacy, a nonprofit tissue and organ donation program that serves the Los Angeles area. First up on Holo, let's get to know 2013 Miss Hawaii Filipina winner, Erica J. Ordonez. Thank you so much, Erica, for being here.
Yes, it's a pleasure to be here. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Now, first of all, congratulations on being Miss Hawaii Filipina 2013.
Thank you. But before we
get into all of that, tell me how you got started and what inspired you to become a part of the pageant.
Well, you know, one of the questions that I was asking myself out of college is, what kind of impact am I going to make?
Uh-huh.
You know, everyone leaves a legacy. How do you want to be remembered once you're gone? And so I was thinking, you know, I've always been a shy and introverted person, but in order to make your dreams come true, you have to surpass those boundaries that you set for yourself.
Right.
You know, and I grew up watching these pageants. My parents would do the video for these pageants. And these girls were amazing. You know, they're so confident, and they have such a huge opportunity to be out there with the public, making a difference in the community.
Yeah.
And so I thought, you know what, why not just go for it?
Yeah.
You know? And so one thing led to another, and I signed up last year. I've never done a pageant.
Never.
No, never.
But you have watched.
Yes, I've watched pageants. Yes,
so,
yes.
But actually, it was more than that, because you wanted to make a difference in our community, the Filipina community. And I know one of the things that you felt very strongly about was Filipinos uniting. Tell me a little bit more about that.
So unity is difficult to achieve anywhere, in any community.
Right.
You know, I mean, there are differences with people, the way that they're brought up. We can't help those. But, you know, when people put all of their energies together, when they put their strengths together, there's so much that can materialize out of that.
Right.
And especially here in the Filipino community, we're the largest ethnic group in the state of Hawaii. And so what that means is we have the greatest opportunity to create a significant, possibly the greatest impact, positive impact to the future. You know, and so my platform was trying to find a way for all of our, you know, all the members of our community to work together, because historically, I mean, it's been a difficulty anywhere, but particularly for us, I mean, there are so many different organizations here in the state of Hawaii, which is great, that perpetuate our culture, but if we were to downsize and, you know, put some of those groups together and, you know, synergize our efforts, there's so much more that we could do
to
create a positive difference.
Speaking of which, you did do a Typhoon Haiyan benefit.
You know, it's so heartbreaking to hear of all the stories, you know, the tragic stories of what happened with that natural disaster. And so I wanted to make a statement in that, you know, a lot of the organizations that were doing these Typhoon Haiyan events were all, you know, big corporations or larger organizations that have a lot of experience. I wanted to show that the youth can also make a significant impact as well.
Yes.
And I wanted to create it in a non-formal environment where people could socialize, the community could get together, enjoy each other's company for a great cause. And so, being Filipino, we had a karaoke night.
And I'm sure everybody in town showed up, right?
Oh, it
we
was
all loved to
sing. Yes. A ton of people came from all ages.
Yeah.
I mean, we had people from 18, 21, around my age, you know, mid 20s, all the way to, you know, older. I won't say what age, you know, we're all young at heart, right?
but a good mix of people, too, right?
We had officials, the consul general came, presidents of some of the organizations, the Filipino nurses, you know,
students,
college students, and all of my pageant queen friends came. Miss Hawaii was there, and some of the other Filipino organization pageant holders, the title holders were there.
Now, speaking of the Philippines, you're actually slated to go and visit, right? And you haven't been there since you were seven?
Seven, yes, I know. So I barely remember anything. My strongest memory is getting lost in the largest mall of Asia.
Oh, I'm sure it's even bigger now,
It is bigger now, so that's definitely unforgettable. But
so you're going to do a lot excited.
A lot of shopping?
Well, no, not so much. I wish I could say that, but I'm going to try and maximize that time to, you know, get to know the people. Mm-hmm. We're going to be visiting the towns that my mom and my great-great-grandparents and my father are from.
Right.
So my grandmother's from Lumban, Laguna.
Okay.
We actually just had a huge family reunion, so I met, you know, Filipino families are always huge, you know, so that was really exciting.
Mm-hmm.
And my father's from San Esteban, Abofasor. Yes, and so the Crown also gave me a lot of opportunities to meet dignitaries. I mean, our organizations here are very proud, so they bring our Filipino.
We are very proud.
Yes, very passionate and proud and hardworking.
Yeah.
So it's fun to perpetuate the culture that way with the title. But yeah, so I'm excited to see all those different places and just reconnect with some of the dignitaries that I've met. Hopefully tour around the towns. I plan
always
to bring
working.
Chocolate with me, you know, for the kids to hand out.
Yeah.
See how we can
always
help
doing
out.
Good.
Well, I mean, that's the greatest thing. You know, I was attending Mass the other day, and you know, we were talking about how people, we're nothing without self-esteem. You know, we're nothing without drive. We're essentially just flesh and bones.
Right.
You know, so if one person, however, you know, little the action may be, can inspire another to feel wonderful about themselves, I mean, that's a success in itself, you know?
Oh.
So I hope that I can inspire someone along the way. If there's a young girl or, you know, a child out there who thinks that they can't do it, there are no barriers.
Yeah.
They're only the ones that you set for yourself.
Oh, very well said.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Very inspiring. And thank you so much for everything you do for our community.
Thank you.
And for representing.
Yeah.
It's been a pleasure.
It's been a pleasure too. Thanks, guys.
Thank you again, Erica. Time for a quick break, but when we return, we talk about saving lives.